हेलो फ्रेंड, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम टू माय चैनल आई बी ऑल डिजाइनिंग डेवलपर। माय नेम इज इंशाल बेग। आई एम अ फुल स्टैक डेवलपर एंड ग्राफिक डिजाइनर। लाइक इन प्रीवियस प्रोजेक्ट वी हैव लर्न दैट हाउ टू बिल्ड वन न्यूज़ फीड प्रोजेक्ट इन जावास्क्रिप्ट एंड आई होप यू ऑल एंजॉयड दैट प्रोजेक्ट। नाउ इन दिस प्रोजेक्ट वी विल सी दैट हाउ टू बिल्ड वन नंबर गेसिंग गेम इन जावास्क्रिप्ट एंड आई होप यू विल आल्सो एंजॉय दिस प्रोजेक्ट लाइक यू एंजॉय माय प्रीवियस प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ जावास्क्रिप्ट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। Now over here you can see I've just made this number guessing game in JavaScript. So in this number guessing game you can see there is written try and guess a random number between 1 and 100, okay? And there is written then you have 10 attempts to guess the right number, okay? So over here it will be just giving you 10 attempts over here to guess a number. It is a random number you have to guess, but it is so difficult over here, but I will just show you how to do. So if I write 20 and here you can see two low try again, okay, means it is not a number which we have to guess. So I will just write another number, so it is also not a number, then like that, okay, so it is also not a number, okay, so I will do like that, okay. So now when you've done that, just you can see that I'm just writing all the random numbers, okay. So here you have to take care of one thing when you are writing numbers, it will be just random and it should be between of 100 1 and 100, okay. So if I write 100, so it will be not also, so it is also not, so it is a last attempt for us to do the correct one, okay. So here you can see game over, the number was 92 which we have to guess, okay. So like that you can make your own guessing game, okay. So first of all you have to open your text editor for making that, and over here I have just created these three files which is called school.html, school.css and school.js, and over here I have just already linked my style sheet also with html sheet, and over here I have also linked my javascript shield which is called script, and I have just already linked it also with my html sheet. So I will just go to my style sheet and I will just come underneath that, and first of all I will write over here guessing game. So I will write guessing game. So when you have done that, just you have to come over here and here you have to write input, okay. So with the with guessing game, underneath that there was a input, okay, where we are writing our numbers which we have to guess. So I will just write first of all like that, and now hit save first of all. Then here you have to go over here and just you have to come over here, and here I will just copy these all the things, and now when you have done that, just you have to come go over here and paste that. So when you have done that, just write over here h1 tag and just copy this again from here, okay. So copy that and paste that over here and erase this thing from here because now we don't need it, this one, okay. So I will just erase that, and now I will write h1 tag over here, and now just you have to copy this close h1 from here, and here you have to paste. So I will paste that, and now here you have to hit save, copy this over here, and just you have to erase that and come over here and paste that over here, okay. So now when you've done that, just come and copy this, and again you have to paste that over here now. So we have done till over here. Just when you've done that, erase that right over here br, okay. So now it's safe. Now when you've done that, just you have to write over here number guessing game. So I will write number guessing game. So now it is done. Just when you've done that, hit save all, and now it is done. Just your html work has been done. So just you have to do your all the work with your css, okay. So first of all I will write input which we have written, okay. So now it is done. Just go to css file, and now over here first of all write margin. So I will write over here margin should be 0 pixel, right over here padding should be also 0 pixel, and right over here like box sizing which should be border box. So I will write border box. So when you have done that, just you have to come and write justify content in center, and now when you've done that, write it in center. Then come over here again and write over here align items in center, and write over here display flex. Okay, so I will write display flex. Now when you've done that, just come over here and write anything which is called font size. So I will just take the font size to 12 pixel. Right over here font weight should be of like 400. And here you have to come and write over here font family. This should be Montserrat. So I will write Montserrat. And just write comma and write sans serif. So I will just take this M capital because it is a first letter, and when you're defining any of the font family, so you have to just take the first letter capital, okay. So just come over here and write flex there, it should be wrap, and write over here float into latch, okay. So we have done till over here. Just you have to copy these all things from here, come over here and write body, and just you have to paste that right over here text align center, and right over here like text justify, okay. So I'm gonna text justify should also be like enter character. So when you've done that, just come over here, and here you have to write anything which is called over here background color. So I will write background color to white, and border should also be white, 1 pixel solid and white. So I will just take 1 pixel solid, and I will just write over here white. So just come and write pixel and write over here white. Now here you have to write the color code of white which we have written right over here. Border color which we have to write should also be white, so I will just take into white. Come over here and right over here outline should be none, okay, because I don't need any of the outline, I need my border, okay. So now here we have turn tail over here. Just when you've done that all things, just you have to do like come over here, okay. So just you have to do like that, and now we have done tail over here. Just you have to come and write over here like just write like that, and now we have done. Just you have to hit save and write over here input, and right over here padding should be like 8 pixel, right margin should be 5 pixel. Now when you have done that, hit save over here, and now when you have done that, I'll just come and write over here text align center over here also. Just now it is done. Now here just you have to do like that, hit save, and now just you have to go to your JavaScript file. Now we have done our work with our HTML and CSS. Now we will do our work with our JS file, okay. So I will just open that, and now over here first of all you have to define function tag. So I will come and write function, then over here I will define this bracket, then come and write over here let, and over here I will write let function equal document dot dot, okay. So just write dot query selector, and now just you have to do like that. Come over here and write function tag over here. Then here you have to do like that. Write let and write body equal document dot query selector. And now when you have done that, just you have to come and write over here again dot. Just I will write body because it is a tag which is of HTML. So I will write let, and again I will just write anything which is called document only equal document dot query selector. And now when you have done that, just you have to come over here and write document over here because it is a tag. So when you've done that, come and write over here body dot add event listener, then come and write button comma add, and write over here like on click function comma array, and write button, okay. So write function now, okay. So I will write function. So when you've done that, just you have to come and again you have to do like right over here, you should come over here and press enter. So just press enter. Now you have to do like that, write random dot floor, right over here math dot length, and now just I will take this m to capital because I need this m should capital because it is a tag which we are writing. We'll write dot button, write function dot on click tag, and I will write over here array again, and write this sign, this curly bracket, come over here and write button dot on click, write over here array comma function tag, and with that said I will write add dot array dot floor, okay, and just erase this u from here, and now write over here dot random. So when you have done that, just you have to come over here again, and here you have to write like document dot query selector, write over here function, so come and write function tag dot array dot random, and write over here dot floor. So when you have done that, just you have to do like that, and now when you have done that all, just you have to come and write over here array dot, and write over here floor random dot function, and here you have to come and write add dot button, and write over here function again. So when you have done that all, just you have to do like that. Now we have done till over here. Just when you have done that, you have to hit save from here, and now if I just show you in the Google Chrome, so just come in over here. So just go to Google Chrome. So over here you can see we have just successfully made it our number guessing game, okay. So over here you can see there's written guess remaining, and over here there's written try and guess a number, random number between 1 and 100, and then it is written you have 10 attempts to guess the right number, and then there is written guess a number. So I will guess the number again. So I will just write 10, it is not, so 20, then 30, 40, 50, 60 is also not, 70, 80, 90, 95, then 92, okay. So now the number was 61 over here, you can see that, okay. So I will just show you how to build over. So if I just do like that again, okay, so here you can see we are just doing like that. So now our number is going again and again, okay. So I hope you understand that how to build a number guessing game with JavaScript, and I hope you understand this project like I'm enjoying my previous project of JavaScript. So just you have to practice this whole project we are working with, and I hope you will be a good programmer of JavaScript also like you are of Python and HTML and CSS. So I will just meet you in next project. So for today, good bye.